除夕和元旦，当其他国家的人庆祝紧新年来临的时候，印度各地有大批民众游行集会，关注印度女性安全问题。引发游行的事件是12月16号首都德里一名23岁的女大学生在巴士上面惨遭6名男子强暴和毒打，经过近两个星期抢救，最终都在12月29号伤重身亡。有媒体根据印度国家罪案统计局数据报道了一个令人心寒的数字，在这个人口全球第二多的国家，每22分钟就有一名女性被强暴。我们联络了印度一位牧师 Shin， 详细了解印度女性安全的情况。
For the centuries people have dominated them actually. Any of my friends or any of the girls here, most of the women will particularly say that they have been touched by some unknown person at least once in their lifetime. Every girl, whether they are traveling, whether they are walking, if it is a womanIt's a very, very tragic situation.
连人身安全这个最基本的需要都得不到保障，引发印度国民连日上街争取对女性安全的重视。
It is not at all a safe place. It is definitely not at all a safe place. And it's happening just because our laws are not much strict as they are in other foreign countries.
现在德里很不安全，简直可以说没人会怕法律条例，我们需要严厉的法律，这样的人犯罪之前就会想清想楚。
有妇女权益组织代表就认为需要建立健全的制度来预防同类案件发生。
在现在的法律制度里面，强奸犯是没有受到应有的惩罚的。现在全国有近40000多宗强奸案在不同地方的法庭等候审理，有一宗2003年的强奸案是要等到2012年才判刑，隔了近9年那么久。如果单单案审理都要等9年，怎会阻吓到人不敢去犯这些严重的罪行呢？所以是很需要订立一个制度来处理这类的案件。
除了经常发生强暴案件，印度女性还面对其他骇人听闻的安全问题，包括由重男轻女思想带来的非法堕胎，很多新娘因为男家父母嫌弃嫁妆太少，最终被杀害，逼未成年少女出嫁的同婚习俗和人口贩卖等等。孙牧师认为，问题除了源于男尊女卑的思想，还有社会阶级之间、宗教信仰之间的仇恨。
They target religion, they target caste, they target education. Most of the Christian women are being targeted. Because once if these girls are getting educated, like the Christian women are, and most of these traditional pathetic mental people do not like it actually. They get attacked thinking that, you know, these people are no more useful. Once if they are targeted by these men, no men will come and marry this woman.And these kids, mostly, unfortunately, these kids will be targeted as well. These women will, you know, rape victims, they might have kids.
孙牧师见到被强暴的女性不单止身心受到巨大的伤害，甚至要独立照顾因而产生的 BB， 还要被社会排斥，不少女性都选择自杀。
So years back, our church has started to care for this woman, women actually, who are being, you know, raped or molested.You know, at the end, most of these women commit suicide. And we have cared for more than 60 kids in our own home. We gave them food, shelter, education. We cared for them. And we have rehabilitated more than 60 kids.
盼望这个年轻女子消逝的生命能够带来印度国民对公义和良知的醒觉，也都提醒不同国家的人为印度守望和祈祷。孙牧师相信只有福音才是最终的出路。
It has to be the mind that has to get the change. For that purpose, they have to accept Christ. It is like bringing light to the heart, where you can identify what is wrong and what is right. Walk like Jesus, behave like Jesus, be treat all human beings as equal as I am.
印度人口里面只有 2% 是基督徒，而且经常受到宗教迫害，但是孙牧师有信心最终能够靠住上帝改变现状。
And we are committed to it. We are going to do it. And we strongly believe that we can make a change. And people like you and your channel and people around, all around the globe and people watching this program can stand up. Maybe you can partner us in prayer. And you can support our projects, and we can make the change.